from a global perspective. It really changes the art of the possible here. We've got the possibility of finding something that is much bigger and much richer than the prior generation of explorationists had considered. Well, you'll notice that we drove up here on a nice network of roads. Now, those roads are from the prior exploration that happened back in the 1970s, a little bit into the 80s, and the roads are still in excellent shape. Yeah, we're here on the northern ridge of the two ridges and the heart of the Hot Breccia property, and a lot is going on over in this area. One of the more significant underground workings that's in the area is the pool mine, which is just to the east of us here. And we've also got another pool mine that is just downslope from us. So a lot of historic workings. Again, looking back at that 1925 annual report from over 100 years ago, we actually see that those mines were well developed at that time. So these are really old workings. And just taking a little bit of a more regional view of things, you can see in the background the Christmas mine, just the upper part of the Christmas mine behind us. So the Christmas property and Hot Breccia are adjacent to one another. And that was a significant producer of copper. Started production before World War I, ended production in 1982, and over that time produced about 25 million tons of 1.5% copper. So high grade, moderate tonnage. But we think it's a really important part of the story here because Hot Breccia may be the roots to the Christmas mineralized system. So very similar to magma mine and resolution. If we look a little bit further afield, 20 kilometers up the road is the significant Ray mine. It's still in production. It's been in production for many decades and really is a significant producer of copper and had some very nice high grade copper as well. So that's a theme that we're continuing to see develop in the regional context, is we've got a lot of high-grade mineralization in this central Arizona copper belt. A little bit further to the north from that, of course, we get to Resolution, and then you go east from there, Globe, Miami, and the Inspiration Pit, all of the Pinto Valley is up there as well. And then about 100 kilometers due east from us is one of the biggest ones that is known in this area. That's the Morenci mine, with over 75 billion pounds of total contained copper. So it's an absolute giant. 35 kilometers to the south of us, San Manuel, which you know, was North America's first block cave, so a very significant deposit in its own right. And it's that was only half of the deposit. The other half was actually sliced off, and Kalamazoo, which is the other half, is still unmined and at depth. These things all tie together in this is a highly mineralized regional district, one of the most significant copper belts on the planet, and we're right at the heart of it. So that just makes the thesis for exploration here at Hot Breccia even more compelling.